Ladies and gentlemen, if I could direct your attention across the field to the 20-yard line, we would like to take a few minutes to recognize the Alma Bacon County Recreation Youth Football Teams, starting with the Midget Raiders, coaches Wesley Merritt. They are sponsored by the Raider Touchdown Club. Next is the Might Raiders, the Gray Raiders, who are coached by Jimmy Gatton, and they are sponsored by Farm Bureau. Next, the Red Raiders, coached by Josh Landis. They are sponsored by Sean's Vinyl. They are followed by the Black Raiders, coached by Rashid Slade, and sponsored by Anytime Fitness. They are followed by the Might Cheerleaders. And their coaches are Casey Smith, Amanda Langford, and April Batten. Next are the Flea Raiders, coached by Heath Carver, sponsored by Fred Kopp. The next Flea Raiders are coached by Garrett Crawford, sponsored by Anderson Pools. And they are followed by the Flea Cheerleaders and their coaches, Harris Bryant and Victoria West. Also coming to the field are the Flag Raiders, the White Raiders, coached by Ryan Carter and sponsored by Cohens of Alma. They are followed by the Red Raiders, coached by Brock Thrift and sponsored by Tyndall Enterprises. Next is the Gray Raiders, coached by Ashley Batten, sponsored by O'Reilly Auto Parts. Next is the Black Raiders, coached by Blake Lewis, sponsored by Merritt Trucking. And the flag cheerleader coaches, Nicole Thrift, Candace Matthews, Tammy Madison, and Amber Garcia. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your recreation teams and cheerleaders, which is also our future Red Raider players and cheerleaders. Give them a big round of applause. Thank you very much.
Tonight, we are honoring Coach John B. Deloach. If your life was influenced by having contact with him and being affected by Coach Deloach, please stand or raise your hand. And we would like to welcome Mrs. Joyce Deloach, John's two girls, Mrs. Tori Deloach Woods and Miss Shay Deloach Riles, their families to the field to receive this memorial gift presented by Monty Bruner, class of 74, Gail Godwin Arrington, class of 77, with the thoughts and efforts of many BCHS alumni of the 70s and early 80s era. Thank you, and you may be seated. In the words of some of the alumni that Coach Deloach mentored, we will reflect. He always saw in us what we could never see in ourselves. And he believed in us when he didn't. No matter our backgrounds or abilities, he pushed us to excel and motivated us to succeed, not just in the classroom or on the field or on the court or even at work. He was more than just a ball coach, more than just a teacher. He was more than just a boss. He was more than just an administrator. He was our life coach. He even taught the girls how to change tires, so he never wanted to see them be stranded on the side of the road. Sometimes it seemed he was too stern, but it was always out of genuine love and concern for everyone encountered. And I'm about to read some quotes that folks turned in. Memories that they sent in, short little things, and I'll follow with their name and their class. Yes, ma'am, no, ma'am, and yes, sir, no, sir. He taught us to be respectful. Mary Lee Sweat, class of 79. Be sure that your cause is correct and honorable. Then give 100%, always 100%. William and I were talking and he said, he's the best example of tough love I've ever had. I second that. He always encouraged me and was supportive. Linda Mitchell Hall, class of 81. Coach taught us how to read a road map for traveling and how important it was. I thank him each and every time I have to use a map. Cleo Little of Merritt Hayslip, class of 85. Slap them, cap them, and let them roll. Georgia Blueberry Association, Robert Sass, class of 82. Back in 82, the Alma Times quotes John Deloach in a personality spotlight, and Coach said, Out of all my accomplishments, I cherish my work with Emmy Smith that allowed so many young people to obtain job experiences as well as some hard-earned money. Compassionate, that's what John was. When Mrs. Bass was hurt and was in a wheelchair for weeks, Coach would go by and pick her up from home and bring her to school. Coach would wheel her into her classroom so she could teach her students. Regina, Taylor, Petroviak. Yeah, with his hands on his hips, legs spread out, and that fierce look on his face, man, I loved it. Debbie Cruz Carter, class of 78. He was a great man. If you had a problem or just needed to talk, he was always there for you. Such a special person, always made time for you. Diane Tootin Sellers, class of 78. I remember his words of wisdom. We all put our pants on the same way, one leg at a time. And be careful who you step on the way up, because you don't know who will be going up when you're coming back down. Cindy Music Papiers, class of 83. Several of us were on his female football team. Not that we saw any action, but he always made a point calling our names and saying it would be the best team he would ever coach.
All right, tonight, right down the road's a big AAA matchup. Applin County is hosting Pierce County. The Bears are down the road. ATCO travels and plays Turner County, who's coming off of a big loss last week to Clinch County as they just got murdered. Clinch County did to them what Turner did to Charlton County. Clinch is at Lanier County. We're going to be watching Statesboro at Ware. Ware coming up. Basically give it. And I think we got Shane, Our Eyes on the Field, brought to you by Family Vision Care down on the sideline. He has an interview, so we're going to go down to him.
Coach Deloach, I grew up in the same church with Coach Deloach. So I knew him as I was growing up, and he was always a mentor. But there were three teachers. I taught school for a while, and there were three teachers influenced probably how I taught school. And Coach Deloach was one. He might break you down, but he was going to pick you back up. And he was the type of person that believed that every person had worth and value, not to give up on anybody. And honestly, that is what probably drove me sometimes as a teacher, was his words in the back of my mind saying, this kid has potential, do not give up on him.
No better testimony than that. So, and what was his words for, I know everybody had a nickname, what was his nickname for you?
Margarita.
Coach Loach had a one for everybody. Margaret, I appreciate it. And y'all. All right, guys, back up to y'all.
Thank you very much, Shane. And we're going back to the studio for our Richmond Baking Coaches Show. You're listening to Red Raider Radio on 93.5 The Eagle.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Red Raider Field or Raider Field here. It's good to be back in Bacon County. The QB, Matt Peavy, here alongside of me is Rev, and we're going to go down for the Man Down Report brought to you by Lamar's Pharmacy to Shane Bennett, our eyes on the field.
Hey, guys, just a few to update you on. Castile is got a pin in his left hand, so he is out for the season. We won't see him anymore this year. Demetrius Williams, just talked to him. He said he's got a sprained MCL, so he's getting better. Said he'll be back shortly. Other notable is Jacob Carver, and he's going to be in there tonight, and we'll see what happens. Just play-to-play, basically, with him.
Five is the yard to gain for the first down here for the Raiders.
Sure looks like it, maybe just 6 inches over.
If you're just joining us, it's still 10 minutes left to go in the first quarter, and Bacon County is on Vidalia's 33. He's going to take the ball and they're going to hand it up the middle to Jacob Carver. First down for the Raiders.
Great blocking on that play. Our offensive line was really pushing and get, you know, surprisingly, we're getting a lot of push against this Vidalia defense.
So far, so good here for the Raiders as we're on their 30-yard line and marching in. 9:52, just under 10 minutes. We've got trips up to the left. Jacob Carver in the backfield with Aubrey. Going to take it. Aubrey's going to drop straight back, and he's going to go deep and try him. And he's got a man.
What did he catch?
My Lord, what a catch. It was a one-handed catch by Ignacio Washington. And he's a game changer, my friend.
That was an awesome play. Great throw.
The
catch was awesome, but Aubrey put the ball exactly where he needed to put it. That was fantastic.
My God, what a catch.
What a play, and what a series by the Red Raiders.
The answer on fourth down and one, and we went for it, the tone. And that's what I'm talking about out of Coach Ken Kofor. I love how aggressive he is. Sometimes he scares me to death, but it sends a message to your team that we're here to play. We're going to attempt the extra point in to kick. Who started kicking last week is Xavier Hayes to attempt. The snap is down. The kick is up, and it's through, and it's good. Here, 9:39, early in the first quarter. Your Red Raiders, 7, Vidalia Indians, nothing. You're listening to 93.5, The Eagle. Red Raiders, if you're just joining us, drove down the field and scored on, was it 8 plays, 9 plays, 10 plays, something like that.
It was enough plays.
That's all that matters. Aubrey Carter's going to be kicking. The ball spotted at the 40, and he's going to kick it, a little pooch kick, and it's going to go to about the 25. Number 14 gets it, and he's a fast little guy. He's going to cut field and finally tripped up, brought down around the 35-yard line. Return of about 9 or 10 on the play.
And we're about to see some new folks. We're about to baptize some new folks in the fire tonight. I understand we're going to get some freshmen that are going to see some playing time. Surprisingly, we've not seen him on the field all year long in a defensive capacity. I see Ignacio Washington out there is going to play. Looks like he may be playing some defensive back tonight.
Ignacio is a veteran in defensive. He played for the last 3 years, actually, as defensive back. Raiders are stacking the line. They're going to hand it wing T, and he just slips outside as we had him. And he runs out of bounds at about the 45-yard line, their 45-yard line, and that's where they'll mark it out. Actually, the 46, we had him in the backfield and just broke the tackle.
Yep. We're still having trouble setting the edge, but we've got to be able to set the edge some way on this buck sweep.
Number 18 for Vidalia, the quarterback, Graham Hall, looks like a fullback.
Yeah, he's a big kid.
Vidalia runs the wing T offense. They will also get in a little I formation and some shotgun if necessary. Here they come out in double wings. The Raiders in a 4-4 set. We're going to send number 2 in motion. They're going to hand it to the fullback.
And he may be gone.
He is gone. Nobody around him. Broken tackle. He's at the 5. 2 plays, touchdown Vidalia. And just like that, it's 7-6.
Well, Coach Kofor told us in the in the coach's show, he told us, he said, we may get burned a little bit because we're just not going to let people continue to punch us. So they went where we were not. We blitzed, had a run blitz, and they went to the other side. And he broke that one tackle. Somebody was trying to arm tackle, and there you go. The score is 7-6.
And one of the keys of the game was that we heard from Coach King Cofer was we're going to have to tackle and tackle well. We're going to go down to Shane Bennett in just a few moments. The kick is up and the kick is good. We're going to stay with us. We go down to our Eyes on the Field brought to you by Family Vision Care. And Shane, I noticed you were down there close to that catch on the opening drive for the Raiders. Walk us through it.
We got you down in the end zone here. That's just another one of those big man makes outstanding catch on. But before you see that, you got to see Aubrey in the read. I mean, he put the ball in the perfect place it had to be. It was just all around offensively was a good play. Defensively, you're going to see a little different set from us last night. And you saw a lot of men up in the box not trying to contain that wing T. But Coach Langford told me before the game, he said, just like I said, we may get burned a few times, but we got some stuff we're going to throw at them.
Well, we could see that early, and not surprised they come right up the middle with it, and that just is not necessarily, attributed to their great play call. It's just that they called us when we were blitzing. If they'd went to the side where the blitz was at, we'd have dropped them for a loss.
We had them. Let's just say that, just a broken tackle on the play. Back deep to receive for the Raiders, standing at about the 10-yard line is Trey Stewart and LeGondrick Snell. And number 20 or so, I don't know his number, is going to kick for Vidalia, and they're going to a little pooch kick it, and it's a good high kick, and we wave off a fair catch at about the 25-yard line, and we'll start at our 25, and out comes that sea of red, the Raider offense, who scored on their opening drive. It's 7-7 here, 9:16, still left in this first quarter. It's been a quick one. We scored on about 8 to 10 plays, somewhere in between there, and Vidalia scored on 2. As their fullback ran it in. We're going to come out here in trips to our out to our right. Aubrey Carter at quarterback, Jacob Carver in the backfield with him. Aubrey give a little hard count there to see if we could pick up a blitz. Now he's calling the play. He's shifting Jacob from his left over to his right. And he's going to take the snap and quick out to Brody Fitchett, and he's met in the backfield as Xavier missed a block, and he's dropped for a loss.
He can't be missing them blocks if we're going to do that. That looked like Georgia last weekend against Missouri.
Just not physical enough.
Just not physical enough. You got to get nasty. You got to do whatever it takes. You got to hit somebody in the face.
That's right. So we're starting off in a hole, second down and 15, 8:52. We're on our 20-yard line. Our backs are kind of up against the wall. Vidalia, they're big. They're shifting around. There's somebody open, wide open in the slot. We never seen him, but we got a man open. My goodness, that was just kind of a crazy play as Vidalia was confused and our slot guy in the middle was running down the seam wide open.
And even our wide guy, our split end there, if he'd kept running, that'd have been 6.
I think he kind of got to looking at the safety coming over the top. We definitely missed an opportunity there. They may not give us that back. Ball still on the 23rd, down and 15, and we've yet to gain a yard. We've actually went back 5 in this second possession for our offense. Going to send Xavier Hayes across the formation in motions, which gives us a trip to the left. Aubrey looks that way, throws it to Inacio, and the ball is complete close to the 30-yard line.
And we're going to probably have to punt it here. We're too deep in the territory not to. We may try to draw them off sides with a hard count.
The most successful punting we've had all year is our little
pooch kick
that Aubrey does end over end, and that ball hits and it rolls. They have nobody back deep. We've got trips, and there we go. We're going to shift into it. And he's just going to kick it. And I don't know that that was a good kick. And it's going to bounce across the 50, 45, and out of bounds. Out of bounds at the 46-yard line. That's where Vidalia will take over in good field position for them. And what happened on that series for the Raiders?
Well, we got behind the sticks. The very first play. You're trying to make something happen, going out wide, getting the ball out into one of our playmakers' hands, and then you have a slot receiver that misses a block, and when that happens, it just drops you for a 5-yard loss, and that's exactly what happened because it was 4th and 6, we had an incomplete pass in between, but if we'd have had some type of positive gain on that first play, then maybe our play calls would have been different, a different result.
Vidalia, the whistle is blown, and see if they're trying to set the clock or what. Vidalia come out in their double wing set with a solo receiver up to the right, but he's in tight, And I don't know what the white hat seen, but he was getting somebody straight down there. So we're going to reset play here. Vidalia double wings, going to send their top guy in motion, going to hand it to that fullback again, and he pounds forward for a gain of 5, maybe 6 yards on the play. And did he cross the 50? If not, yep, he's spotted at the 49-yard line, and they're in our territory with 7:50 here to go in the first quarter.
Second and 4, and we can't have them kind of first downs. We need to get them long in this offense. You got to have them third and long, second and long, and if they're able to get 5 and 6 yards on the first down, it's going to be a long night.
Pierce County's up early, 7-0 on Applin. Vidalia going to send a guy in motion. He's going to drop back to pass. And oh, we had him, and they got a game wide open. And that ball is caught. And if it was a – we almost had the quarterback in the backfield. Matter of fact, thank God we hit him, because if we didn't, the guy would have ran in for untouched for
somebody,
a touchdown.
Somebody missed their read altogether there. Maybe he came from where we were blitzing. I'm not sure.
Well, I will say this. If we bring the house and do that kind of thing, Vidalia is good enough just to dump it off all night long. So we're going to have to watch it and be careful. Running under 7 minutes here. Vidalia comes out. Got single coverage down to the bottom. They're on the 30-yard line. They're going to hand it to their fullback. And
good play.
We stop him after a gain of probably 2 yards, make it second down and long. I think if we can keep them in those situations, second, third, and long, we'll be in good shape.
That was a good play by Jesus Brown, bringing him out, and they're bringing Akeem Peterson in. We're just going to keep continuing shuffling people in and out, trying to keep some fresh bodies in there. It's going to be a long ball game, and it is a little bit humid tonight.
Tyler Wilcox come onto the field for the Raiders as well. They're in their double wing set. You're going to send number 10 in motion, and it's going to be a pitch, and he's got a couple blockers. And a broken tackle or two, and he's across the 25, and it'd be short of a first down, and it'd bring up a third down and 3 or 4 yards. Well, our Raiders are out there, but we just not making that first initial tackle.
I don't know who that was, number 6 for us, Sean Morgan.
He's played a lot for us this year.
He did, but just then he kind of looked like a deer in the headlights. He didn't know what to do. He was trying, didn't know whether to attack or what happened, and he just went right by him.
Number 10 running the ball for them is Tyler Roundtree.
He's just a sophomore.
Just a sophomore. So here we go, big third down for the Raiders. 5:48 ticking. They're on our 25. They're going to hand it to their big guy, number 15, who's got a hole and a first down as he crosses the 20-yard line down to the 19-yard line of the Raiders. First down, Vidalia. They just really just blew us off the ball there.
Well, they're just bigger than we are. It's been the story all year long on our defensive front. We're just not very big. And, you know, eventually somebody that weighs you 40 pounds is going to be able to get some push against you.
And not to mention that we were without Inacio Washington. I mean, Ametrius Williams. I always get those two mixed up, and K.J. Castile tonight. Vidalia is going to take it, and they're going to hand it on a little speed sweep, buck sweep, and we bring him down. A good tackle by Anthony Madison, who come off the backside and brought him down after a gain of 1, second down and 9 on the play.
That was a good play by our defensive back, who came out and actually stymied the play. The pulling guard, he hit him and made the running back turn back inside where we got help. The problem is when they are able to knock us out and they're able to get the edge on us.
Slowed him up so that the backside linebacker could catch him. Good play there by our DB. 4:45 and ticking here in the first quarter. They're on the 18-yard line of the Red Raiders, and they're going to do a quick speed.
And
they got
score.
Some guys out.
He's going to score.
Untouched. Is there? Oh, we bring him down at about the 2-yard line, and that's going to be a first down. As they just pitched it out to the guy to the right, the strong side of the field, and phew.
I mean, you could see from the very get-go, they totally collapsed us inside. We had nothing. We had nothing.
Folks, if you're listening to us, if we're going to be in this ball game, it's going to be a shootout.
Yep. They're just outmanning us up front right now, and I don't know that we got an answer for it.
Turnover is always an answer.
That's about the only thing, the answer.
They're going to send it in motion. They're going to hand it to their big guy, and he dives in for the touchdown, and that'll be the second touchdown of the night. 4:07 here left in the first quarter, and Vidalia is up 13-7 on the Raiders.
Well, that was quick and methodical, and that's just what they're going to do. And we can look for it all night. And we've been exposed on film, and we can expect that the rest of the season. People are going to try to get our edge, and it's the edge that kills us. It's the edge that killed us right there. They got to the edge, collapsed us down, and may have missed that.
Nope. The kick is up and good. And then here, 4:07 here at Raider Field in Bacon County, Vidalia Indians 14, your Red Raiders 7. Don't turn your dial. We'll be right back with Red Raider football on 93.5 The Eagle. And two plays and a first down.
Very, very close to a first down. I think we got it.
They knocked one of our linemen in the backfield, but Jacob made a juke around him and got 2 yards. Well, they're going to just give it spotted a little closer than what it was, and we may have a measurement. Xavier Hayes coming off for the Raiders and Anthony Madison coming onto the field. Usually when Anthony comes on, we're either fixing to run it or we're going to sneak
face
him out in the flats.
Against them. I see the laundry.
Awesome.
Fantastic. Oh, we're going to take the play. We're lining up ready to go. We got to mark off the penalty.
That's what everybody's hollering. I'd be interested to find out and see if that is a lady referee down on the field that's spotting the ball right now. Maybe our eyes on the field, Shane, can find that out.
Guys, it definitely is.
Awesome. I think that's the first time we have seen that in high school football here in Bacon County. And it's always interesting to see. However, Bacon County first down, and Jacob's going to take it. And Aubrey keeps it on the read option, and he's knocked back for a loss of one on the play.
Should have handed it then, but hindsight's 20/20 always.
Second down and 12. And for the Raiders, as that was a run, quarterback run option, it come good for us on that 4th and 2 early on. Got Trips out here, and he's going to take, Augie's going to tape it and roll it, and he's got a man wide open, and catches it at the 35. First down for the Raiders.
Boy, that play has been good for us this year, and Anthony Madison did not disappoint. The ball's a little bit high. What?
Aubrey's down at the 35, but he's up and he's going as he took a lick after he threw that ball. He's bending over. He's going to hang in there, and let's see what's going to happen. The referee calls a timeout. And, Shane, our eyes on the field, did you see what happened to Aubrey on that play?
Yeah, guys, we had it real close to being late here there and just took him out at his knees pretty much.
So they took him out. I noticed there was nobody around when he threw the ball. So be interested to see. I wish we had some replay here in this stadium. However.
Yeah, there was somebody around. The white hat was standing right there.
Right on top of it, but it didn't call it. He let him play there, and they're checking him out on the sideline. That's going to be – we're going to pay attention to that. Aubrey has played outstanding for us, and we just want to thank Family Vision Care for allowing us to go down to the sideline this year. It's been a nice addition to the radio team this year, and Shane Bennett has done an outstanding job all year long. And so that's going to bring in the young sophomore, Dawson Jewell, who has played very well for the Raiders at times this year.
Well, he has played good for us at times. You know, last week he had the game-sealing drive. He was able to get the ball around. He's a little bit more elusive as far as being able to run the ball. But he's a little bit more of a gunslinger than what Aubrey is, too.
Ball spotted at the 33-yard line of the Vidalia Indians, and we come out in Trips. Aubrey's out. Dawson Jewell's in at quarterback. And let's see, the white hat's trying to get things situated here as they're coming out of basically an official timeout, checking on Aubrey still down there. Our team doctor is checking on him.
They got a sideline warning against the Vidalia team. The side judge over on the far side of the field has thrown the flag just as a warning, trying to get the coaches back up off of the sideline so he can move around over there.
Our cheerleaders are doing a good job right down in front of us, getting our 12th man up on their feet here. It's 1st and 10 for the Raiders. Under 3 minutes to go. Ball snapped, and you're going to hand it to Jacob Carver, and people are all over him in the backfield at the snap. It was a high snap that just threw off the timing, and it's going to be 2nd down. And
we've had trouble
two.
With that all year long, you know. And I don't want to, you know, call the kid out because he's played good for us all year. But when Jesus is in there at center, we seem to have trouble with the exchange.
He does snap a little bit high, but he plays both ways. Peter Simmons is also the backup. Jules going to roll it and try to get to the edge, and he throws it to a man. What a throw by Jules, showing his arm strength. It's complete at the 30-yard line, a gain of about four to be third down and seven.
Well, I saw the EMTs looking over Aubrey, giving him, you know, shine the light in his eyes, some of that what they call concussion protocol, and he's still got his hat on, so it looks like he's going to be all right.
And that's big.
Yeah, guys, they checked him out. He seems ready to go. He just wants to get back in the game right now.
Yeah, I saw him come up and tap Coach Ken Cofer, saying, hey, man, let me back in.
Big third down here as Brody Fitchett comes across in motion. We're going to throw it quick out there to one of our young wide receivers, and he's not going to get a first down, but get a gain of maybe four, and it'll be fourth down and probably four.
Yep.
On the play. Ball's at.
Well, they're marking it. Let's see.
That was LeGondrick Snell, or was that Anacio? That was LeGondrick Snell at the top. He's quick, and it's fourth down and three for the Raiders. Ball is marked at Vidalia's 26-yard line, and Aubrey's coming back in at quarterback for this big, crucial fourth down. If you're listening to us, say a quick prayer because we need to answer Vidalia. It's 14-7 here as we're ending the first quarter. Vidalia has scored at will and done whatever they want to.
Offensively.
We're going to come out, and they send a blitz, but Aubrey gets outside the pocket, and he dumps it to a man wide open at the 15, the 10, the 5. Hold on to the ball. He's dancing around. Touchdown, Washington. What a play. Great job by Aubrey Carter.
Aubrey Carter made that play happen. He hit Anacio Washington in the breadbasket, and he turned around and does what he does, which is he's very elusive, and he's very, very quick, and he went through just kind of a surgeon-like. He just kind of danced around and got into the end zone. Fantastic.
Well, I tell you what, those two have been playing lights out last week against Jeff Davis and this week so far. It's been the Aubrey Carter and Anacio Washington show as far as scoring goes. We're going to give credit to everybody on our offense. They have to block. Jacob Carver gets us down there, but as far as scoring, that's been their show. The kick is up, and the kick is off to the right as Xavier Hayes misses his first kick, and it's 14-13, and sometimes you just can't get a break.
Well, you can't, and we're getting a lot of pressure. We're getting a lot of pressure coming in from if you're looking, we're actually was going in from the left to the right. If you're looking, coming in from our right side, they're getting a lot of pressure off, and they've almost blocked it, and that time the pressure may have made us shank it a little bit. But this was a good answer, 14-13. We're a two-point conversion away from being ahead. That's the way you got to look at it, and we've had plenty of two-point conversions this year.
Man, we're just playing lights out right now. Under a minute here in the first quarter, it's 14-13. Vidalia is on top, and we're going to come out to kick. The kickoff, Monroe 7, Cairo nothing, Pierce County 14, Applin County 7, that's a game right down the road. In single-A action, Turner County 15, Atco 0, Irwin County 7, Wilcox 6, Seminole 14, Berrien County 7, and we're looking for some Ware County scores and scores from around the region. We'll keep you up to date. Aubrey sets the ball at the 40-yard line, and he's going to kick it off, a little pooch kick that's going to go to about the 25-yard line. Number 14 receives it, and he cuts across the field, and it looks good for a minute, breaking a couple tackles, and we finally bring him down at the 39-yard line, and that's where Vidalia has been all night long, opening up.
We got to have a stop some way. We need something to happen. We need a miscue. We need something to happen to stop so we can swing and turn this field position a little bit and also get the ball going back in our favor. Rather than playing behind, we continue to play ahead.
If we can create something, and you always want to as a defense, and we have at times, you go back to the Pierce County game on a big interception by Wesley Cothran to win the game. And I don't know when the last time is our defense has had a takeaway.
It's been a while. Sure has.
So it's time tonight. We're back playing in front of our 12th man tonight, and this is a big region ball game for us. Vidalia, number 18, walks his guys to the line, and it's basically going
to
be an empty
to the
backfield.
Right. Nope.
And they're going to do a speed sweep, and he cuts up the field. That guy
is gone.
Quick. And we got a Raiders chasing him down. He's across the 30, the 25, and we're running him down from behind. Wesley Cothran brings him down at the 12, and that ball come out. And number 10 is getting up a little bit slow, but you talk about that, the fastest guy on the field for the Raiders. Wesley Cothran ran him down, and that guy's not slow at all.
No. But it's we've got to be able to do something to stop this on the side. I mean, we're just I don't know. I don't know what we're going to do.
One play there on the 9-yard line, first and goal for Vidalia. Number 10, the Roundtree guy for Vidalia, he is he's a good-looking athlete, and we have no answer so far for them. They're going to come out in a true wing right or wing left, and Coach Kofer is going to call a timeout there. With Coach Kofer, we're going to take a quick break and go back. We want to thank you for listening to 93.5 The Eagle.
In this moment, it doesn't matter if you save money in 15 minutes. It doesn't matter if your neighbor has the same insurance that you do. What matters right now is the quality of your independent insurance agent.
Glad you're okay, Sarah. We'll take care of everything.
And the company that stands behind them.
Thanks so much for your help.
No problem.
Auto Owners Insurance.
Bennett, Bennett & Johnson Insurance Agency in Alma is your local independent auto owners insurance agency.
Had an answer for their offense so far. We're banged up on the defensive side of the ball. We're missing our big guy, Metris Williams. We're missing KJ Castile, as KJ's out for the season. If you are just joining us or haven't heard yet, wish him the best of luck. He had surgery yesterday on his, had some pins put in.
And we're not playing Jacob Carver in the middle. We've hardly played him for the last two games. He just doesn't have quite the movement we're using him, and feel like we need him more in the offensive side of the ball. I wouldn't be surprised to see him come in sooner or later, though.
They're going to hand it to him, and a couple broken tackles as we in the backfield.
Oh, goodness. That was a terrible spot. He actually bounced on his knee, and they let him fall forward. He actually was a yard to 2 yards farther back where they spotted it. Come on, guys.
Ball spotted at the 6-yard line, and that's going to be the end of the first quarter here in Bacon County. The Indians of Vidalia 14, Bacon County 13. We're going to take a station break. You're listening to 93.5 The Eagle. We're going to go down to Shane Bennett as he has some first-time stats for us. Our eyes on the field brought to you by Family Vision Care. Shane?
Hey, guys. Bacon County on the running side of the ball, 17 yards on 8 carries. Passing 9 for 11 for 83 yards for 100 total yards in that first quarter. Vidalia, on the other hand, 10 rushes for 156 yards, and they were two for 2 in the passing area for 22 yards for a total of 178. We just got to contain these guys.
Contain them is the key. They've got a second down and goal here. Ball is on the 6. They're going to take it and hand it to number 6. He's up there at the 2, and he's knocked down and drove back at the 2-yard line by one of our Raiders, and that's a big play because it brings up a third down from the 2.
Who was that? Was that KJ?
I don't know. Our guy from BCTV, Trey Stewart, number 17, is what is being reported. Trey's played very good for the Raiders. He transferred from Coffee County last year, was unable and ineligible during football season, but he's back and played very well for us. It's a big third down here from the 2-yard line. Third down and goal. They're going to take it, and they're going to hand it to their fullback, and he's in for a touchdown. No, the quarterback's in for a touchdown as he pulled it.
Okay, now we just need a block extra point or a shank or something, so keep us just within a touchdown and extra point to tying it up. It's going to look like it's going to be one of those Pierce County nights.
They tried to give us a taste of our own medicine with a little read option and almost got himself in trouble. Yep. But I told you, remember when I told you that quarterback looked like a fullback that time he needed his size to drive in as we had him in the backfield. A snap, a kick is up, and the kick is good. And that makes it 21-13 here early in the second quarter. Raiders are going to get the ball back. We just have no answer so far. We just have no answer for these Vidalia Indians as we can't slow them down. And I just, you know, after several games of not being able to stop the run, it just comes clear that we're just going to struggle with that.
We don't have the behinds. Yep. We don't have enough weight.
But I tell you what, we can do. We can score some points.
And we're quick and we're fast. And we're playing. Our Coach Kofer and them is doing all they can with the personnel that we've got.
Doing a great job.
Doing a fantastic job, to be honest. We just we need some big heavies. And for a South Georgia bunch, I don't know where our big boys are at. They must be sitting in the classroom or sitting in their four-wheel drive truck or whatever. But our big boys are not out on the football field.
Got some scores for you. Applin County 14, Pierce County 14. That's a dog fight. Statesboro 3, yeah. Ware County 7. And no score from Jeff Davis or Brian yet. We're going to be paying attention to that. Number 23 is set to kick for Vidalia Indians. Ball spotted at the 40 in the middle. And this time he's going to kick it deep, and it's going to be back. Trey Stewart's going to catch it at about the 8. Got to set up. He crosses the field, and Trey's got some speed. Met in the backfield. He breaks a tackle, and there he goes. He's down the sideline at about the 40-yard line and finally brought down as he punishes the kicker at the 48-yard line.
Boy, that was huge. The kicker's walking off kind of sideways. If you ever seen a run-over dog, he just kind of limped there. In fact, they got 3 people limping off the field.
Trey Stewart reversed his – I mean, he caught it down in the corner down here at the 8 and went all the way across the field and punished somebody. The ball is at the Raiders.
47-yard line.
47-yard line, and they're going to blow a whistle and got an official timeout as they're still got some guys. It's calling an official timeout, and the Raiders – I don't know what that's for.
I don't either. You're listening to Red Raider Radio on 93.5 The Eagle.
In this moment, it doesn't matter if you save money in 15 minutes or if your neighbor has the same insurance that you do. What matters right now is the quality of your independent insurance agent and the company that stands behind them. Auto Owners Insurance.
Bennett, Bennett, and Johnson Insurance Agency in Alma is your local independent auto owner's insurance agency.
Raiders come back up on the field, and Aubrey Carter back in at quarterback, and Jacob Carver's going to be backing him up.
Going to send Xavier Hayes across the formation to give us trips, and we've got a blown whistle and a false start.
Boy, we don't need to get behind the sticks.
Behind the sticks early, as that's going to bring up first down and 15 and back us up to the 44-yard line here. 10:58 left to go in the second quarter, and it's 21-13, Vidalia on top. We've really had no answer for them, and they've stopped us one series on offense. Other than that, we've looked pretty good. We've got light issues up here. Turn the lights off. Trips out here to the left. Jacob Carver in the backfield. Aubrey gets the snap. He hands it to Carver, and he's got a hole or two, and he runs over a guy after a gain of about 4 on the play, and that'll bring us back to the original line of scrimmage. Their coaches is out on the field. I'd like for one of those referees to actually bump him so we can get 15 yards here. They're not being disrespectful. They're just coaching, but it sure would be nice to catch him off guard. Jesus Brown comes limping off the field, but that means nothing because we're the Wounded Warriors, and there comes Jacob Carver limping off the field. That's not good. And K.J. Brown comes in. 9 minutes of ticking on the play clock. Aubrey going to take it. He's going to fake it. He's looking. He throws way across the field, and it's caught. As that was a long throw for our quarterback, but a good throw. We finally crossed the 50 here, and it's going to be third down and about 5 for the Raiders.
Well, that was a good throw, but if LeGondrick had, rather than going down to catch it, if he'd just come a step or two in, catch the ball, he could have caught the ball moving and would have been able to turn it up the field for a nice gain.
Says the ex-wide receiver from Ware County in 1980, way back yonder. We got Twins to the right and to the left, and K.J. Brown is in for Jacob Carver in the backfield. Aubrey Carter standing, sends Brody Fitchett across the formation in motion. Going to take the ball and drop straight back. He's looking, and he's under pressure, under rest, and that ball's out. Nope, he picks it back up.
Calls him down at contact. It's going to be fourth.
That was close to a disaster.
It looks like fourth and nine.
As they sack him on the play, and that's the first time that they had our guy covered and made Aubrey step up into the pocket.
Vidalia, this is huge right here now. I don't know what we're going to do. He's going to have to punt it.
Vidalia athletic. Bacon County's very athletic. But then you add size to Vidalia, and that's been the difference so far tonight. I get tired of saying that every year, but that's exactly what we face. Empty set for Aubrey at fourth down and nine. He's going to take it, and he's going to kick it end over end. Ball's going to hit it at the 25, and a great roll.
And great decision by our coach.
Good job by our coaches as Vidalia is going to take over at about the 12-yard line for their next possession on their offense. 8:48 here to go in the second quarter. It's 21-13, and if we've ever needed a stop this year, this season, we need to stop right now.
It's huge right now. Coach Cofer's talking with Aubrey, and he's trying to tell him about maybe it looked like Vidalia was switching up coverages on us, and when we got the snap, we looked around, and we were covered. So I think we were not able to pick up the coverage pre-snap, so maybe that's what happened. At least that's what it looked like to me. Tell me about it, quarterback. Is that what it looked like to you?
It looked like they just covered well to me. There wasn't much shifting going on. It looked like he just broke in on him. They're going to hand it to number 10. Wow. He's around the corner, but we're there, and hard 2 yards for them.
But if you notice their running backs, when we do hit them, they fall forward for two.
Yeah, they do. They do a very good job. Not only that, they're just kind of shifty, man. They're kind of shifty. They'll cut that thing up and hit it hard, and they're really quick. It's second down, however, and 7-8 is what they're marking it on the scoreboard. It looks more like 7 to me. 8:20 here in the second quarter. It's 21-13 Vidalia. They come out in a double wing set. Going to send their man in motion to hand it to their fullback, and we had a guy back there. He still gained 2 yards on the play. We had a guy that ran right by him, Rev.
Yeah, but we were able to stop him. I'm looking for Jacob Carver and see what he's doing on the sideline, if I see him moving at all.
We'll go down to Shane Bennett after we hold him here on third down and draw a punt, see if he's got any news on Jacob Carver in just a few minutes. However, it's third down and 6. If you're listening to us, stand on your feet unless you're driving down the highway. Please don't do that. They've got an empty backfield. They're going to send a man in motion, and they're going to quick pitch it. But however, there is a false start.
Fantastic.
On Vidalia.
That's the first mistake they've made all night.
And it comes in big as they are.
They were fixing to pitch it to our wide side, and it looked like they were pulling the whole team. It looked like they'd already collapsed us.
And that's going to bring the ball back to about the 12-yard line, and it'll be third down and 11 for the Raiders. And Vidalia's backs are against the wall. This is the worst field position of the night for Vidalia, and I'm glad that we turned it over. Let's just see if we can hold. I sure would like to see our 12th man stand up on their feet here as they're getting a little bit loud now. That student section's leading the way. And this time they're going to drop it back. They're going to get him. We got a man in the backfield.
Fantastic.
And he's dropped for a loss.
Yes.
Great play by the defense and timely play.
Yes.
That was one of our young cornerbacks. That's Jesus Brown shot off the edge. No, Anthony Madison. I tell you, it's hard to see these numbers up here. Anthony Madison come flying in. And I tell you what, Anthony's been quiet the last couple of games. But do you remember the beginning of the year? He played huge
for us. Yes.
I mean, so it's good to see him finding his zone now. And so back deep.
The ever dangerous Trey Stewart.
The Raiders is Trey Stewart, and I imagine they'll try to kick it away. Trey is standing at about the 38-yard line, and any way this goes, we should get the ball on our side of the 50.
Unless this kid just really bangs it.
We'll see. Vidalia has been known for having kickers, and they're going to milk it down, and they get it off just in time. He drops it, but we had no pressure. End over end kick.
Stay away, Trey.
Oh, my goodness. My goodness, Trey Stewart.
Dangerous.
Good Lord, he picked up that ball.
man, if we'd have just had somebody back there, we'd have had a safety.
Yep, we had the punter dropped it like Michigan, living that all over again almost, except this time he didn't throw it to our guy. That was a crazy play this past weekend. Trey Stewart, if I could get a hold of him right now, I'd grab his chin strap and say, what were you doing?
He caught the ball, bounced and kicked up to him, but it was with the Vidalia defenders all over him.
We get the ball. Ball's at the 45-yard line, our 45-yard line, and Aubrey Carter's in at quarterback, and we draw him off sides, and so it'll bring up a first down and five, and that's going to spot the ball at the 39-yard line.
Fantastic. Fantastic.
Good
job. We're at the 39-yard line. We have flipped the field position, something we were hoping to do.
And that just comes from great coaching. That's all I can tell you. If you're watching this game, Vidalia has beat us up and down the field offensively, and our coaches have found a way. Aubrey's going to drop back, and he's got a man. He throws it out there. First down. He's hit immediately. Dropped at about – they're going to spot him close to the 30. I can't – is that the 30, the 32-yard line?
Yes.
But it'll be first down for the Raiders at the 32.
First down.
And we're marching. 6:13 here in the second quarter. It's 21-13, and I wouldn't mind if we ran about 5 minutes off this clock
scored. I hope our wide receiver's looking where he's lined up out here.
Trips are to the left, and Aubrey's got some pressure, and he throws it to a man at the 25, Xavier Hayes. Caught.
They're blitzing linebackers every play. If we just had a tight end or somebody, maybe our our tailback or something. Of course, our tailback's having to stand in and block.
So that was a hot route. That was a good read there by Aubrey, and he stood in as the blitzing linebacker come. They're going to take it, hand it to Wesley Copter, and for the first time, he breaks a couple of tackles. He's at the 15, first down Raiders.
Fantastic play call.
One of the
Wesley
things,
hold on to the ball. He almost got it pulled out from behind, which is not unusual. But he held on to it.
One thing about Wesley Copter, I've noticed this year, is he's become a little more shifty. He looks for those cutback lanes, and there he cut back a couple times. First down, however, ball at our 15-yard line. 5:33 and ticking. Aubrey takes it, sticks it in the belly, pulls it out. He's dropping back, looking for a man, and he just throws it out there and up. And my goodness, what was he doing?
He wasn't thinking very much. And in comes Jacob Carver.
Aubrey was trying to throw it out of bounds, but he was
throwing off his back foot.
Back foot, and that ball, man, that was dangerous. However, we avoided that, and it's going to bring up second down and 10. And here we go. We're bringing in our speedy guys, Anthony Madison, Dawson Jewell, K.J. Brown coming in, along with Jacob Carver. Nacio Washington and LeGondrick Snell stay at wideouts, both one to the left and one to the right. They're looking back and getting the signals from our coach, Matt Williams.
13 seconds left on the play clock. We're milking it down. We need to be careful with it.
Still got a timeout in our pocket. 6 seconds. Here we go. Three, and we're going to shift. And it's a delay of game, dadgummit, a delay of game on the offense as we couldn't get it called fast enough. And that's going to back us up second and 15.
That's ridiculous. You can't get a delay of game call in that situation, not with timeouts to burn. Nope, can't have it. But it happens. It's high school football. That happens. Don't look like it bothered us at all, does it? I don't think 15 yards bothers this team. The reason I don't, because we're one play away from getting a first down. Because 15 yards with our offense, it just doesn't bother us.
This time we're going to shift everybody to the left, and he's going to take it, and we busted play again, and we throw a pick.
Intercepted.
Dawson Jewell confused, and we're not bringing him down. Jacob going to hound him down and push him out of bounds. Ball at the 50-yard line, and there comes the youth and inexperience. Just takes the breath out of you. Folks, if you're listening, they just threw a pick, and I'll be honest with you, on the play, if I'm just calling it the way I see it, it looked like it was a busted play, did it?
It did. He turned around to hand the ball, and it's just stupidity.
I'll say it. You don't want to say it. I'll say it. 5 minutes here, 5:13, second quarter. 21-13 is your score. Vidalia with the first turnover of the game and just can't afford it. So here we go, defense. Let's stand up and see if we can get another stop as they did last. They come out in double twins. Number 10 going to take it, and they're going to roll out, and they're going to throw it, and that ball bounces. We had it covered, really. He was sort of open, but we had some guys out there. Second down and 10. on the
play.
I wouldn't
be surprised, bringing Jacob in, I wouldn't be surprised to see him blitz right here, try to create some havoc.
It's good to see Carver out on the field like that. And we've got to have a stop here. We can't afford to give them any more momentum going into halftime. And we can do it because we played very well.
Well, it sure is good to be first in or second and 10 this time.
And they're going to hand it to their fullback, and we meet him, Jacob Carver.
Oh, yeah, baby.
In the backfield.
Oh,
hits him at
yeah,
the
baby.
50-yard line, and that'll be third down and 8 or 9 for Vidalia. And here comes another big third down, 4:53 here in ticking. Ball's on the 49 where they mark it.
That
21-13
was a football play. He spun that big fullback that's been having his way with our little defensive lineman. That time we brought the lightning and the thunder.
Linebacker
spun him around.
Did what he was supposed to do. Is he rolled down and filled in well.
They're going to the right probably.
Empty backfield, and this time they're going to toss it to number 10. He's got a couple blockers, and we bring him down close to a first down at about the 43-yard line. And I was just gritting my teeth there, hoping he was dragging one of our guys, but there is a flag.
Oh, Lord,
man,
please.
And that better not be a late hit. Goodness gracious. Oh, it's going to be
a personal foul against them.
He said false start. Maybe personal foul. I know that's a crazy thing, but I thought he rolled his hand.
Personal foul
against Vidalia, and that's going to be a mark off. That's going to be one to remember if we can pull out a victory tonight. Hey, credit our defense.
Yep.
Good job, boys.
I don't know what it was. It was something was going on over there on the sideline. I don't know if the side judge ran into a coach over there that was standing close on the sideline. I don't know. They had already been warned. That may have been what it was. I didn't really see anything flagrant from a player standpoint.
And they're going to bring out their punting unit, as they should, and Trey Stewart's going to have an opportunity. And, boy, I tell you what, I'd go after that kicker. If you remember, Trey Stewart lit him up, and he dropped the punt last time he come out. So he might still be on cloud nine, nobody know it. Their punter's going to stand at about the 29-yard line. Ball is on the 42 after the personal foul. Trey Stewart standing back at about the 25. The punt's over his head, and we're rushing to it. The ball's rolling around, and he dives on
it. Fantastic. We get the ball right
line.
Back where we were at.
And good Lord, we get a chance to revive ourselves.
Boy, that saved us. Thank the Lord in heaven.
And that's a great play for Vidalia. Thank you, Vidalia.
We've been waiting, haven't we? That's awesome.
Great job by our defense and our defensive coaches. As it looked like we couldn't stop them in the last two series, by George, we have bowed our necks and stopped them. However, we've got trips out here. Ball's on the 9-yard line as we're going to be marching in. Aubrey Carter waiting for the official to blow the whistle. He takes it and he hands it. He pulls
no,
it.
No.
And he's dropped for a loss on the play. Loss of 2. Thank God they blew the whistle. As it wouldn't have mattered if he handed it to Jacob or kept it himself. They were just in the backfield.
I have no idea where our blocking was on that play because we sure didn't touch nobody.
I think they blew by us before we were ready. However, it's second down and 12 here. Ball on the 17. Aubrey drops straight back, and he's looking. He dumps it to Jacob Carver, who's out in the flats, runs over a guy, lands at the 15-yard line.
We're back at the original line of scrimmage.
Third down and 10. And I don't know. I don't think that had – it looked like a screen at first, but I honestly think, Rev, that they are just literally blowing by our offensive lineman right now.
Well, we need to bring down our splits or need to do something.
You're going to send Brody Fitchett across the motion, and it's going to give trips to the right. And Aubrey's going to roll that way. He's going to set him up in the pocket. Got a man wide open, and it's caught. And a ball comes out as we fumble it again, and they pick it up. I don't know. We may have jumped back on it. We're going to wait for the signal. Our young receiver just dropped it, and it's going to be first down, Vidalia. My goodness, my goodness.
Well, we were carrying it out there like the – like my old coach said, you can't be toting the ball like a loaf of bread, son, because I had that same thing happen to me before.
And
we're
I don't
running
know.
The ball, and somebody comes up from behind you, and you got the ball away from your body instead of high and tight.
And that was our senior playmaker, Ignacio Washington, on the fumble.
We got it's a big series right here. We didn't let the momentum of their play interception stop us last time, so we're going to have to stop them again right here.
Let's still hunker down here. Let's go, guys. As old Larry Munson used to say, we have no safety in the backfield, and they're going to take it and hand it number 10, and we bring him down after a gain of about three.
Good tackle by Wesley Cawthorn then. I tell you what, just bringing in Jacob Carver in the middle there and knowing what he can do has seemed to help us a little bit in our run game. 2 minutes and 43 seconds left. Vidalia is on their own 27-yard line, and second down and seven.
Second down and seven, like you said. We're having a little technical difficulties with our sideline guy, and we're just trying to figure out some things up here. Hopefully we can hear from Coach Cofer. They're going to take the ball and hand it to number 14, and he's got a hole, and we hit him hard and just short of a first down, but it's manageable for them as it's going to be third down and about two.
2 minutes and 11, 210, 209, clock is ticking. We need it to run.
The ball is spotted at our 33-yard line or 32-and-a-half-yard line, and it's third down and one. And like you said, all night long they fell forward.
Our fans are getting up, calling for a big stop right here.
This is a big third down for the Raiders. And we're stacking the line, and their quarterback falls forward and gets it. He's still rumbling. A big gain of about four or five on the quarterback sneak. And that was a case of picking the gap that no linebacker was coming through.
Yeah, he fell forward, got 2 or 3 yard gain. He's a big boy, like
he
you said.
He almost broke it on that play. Good job by our guys of cleaning him up.
What does he look like? He weighs about 215 probably?
He's thick, man. He's thick.
He's not very tall. I mean, when I say that, he's probably 5'11", but he weighs about 215. He's just a big boy.
They're going to come out in their wing, and they're going to hand it to their big guy. Drop back to pass, and he's running. He's got outside, and we've got holding. It looks like the flag is going to be thrown by the white hat. The ball is complete, however, at the 42. And it's going to be holding on Vidalia, 116 going. If we can hold them off here, man,
yeah,
you just
really
go
into
really
halftime.
Good.
Yeah, go into halftime at a 21-13 score, and we've had our opportunities. What you think about that, QB?
Oh, we've been inside the 15-yard line twice and given the ball back to them. So that, if you add that into it, we may look back and we've had our chances. You're absolutely right. Just things cannot happen.
Yeah.
However, that's going to back them up. Put the ball at.
Wow.
25-yard line, and it's going to be first down and forever. And knowing Vidalia, they're going to run the clock out here.
I'd say first down and 23.
We are
a minute and 4 seconds left.
And they're going to take it and hand it to number 10, and we got him in the backfield. Gang tackled by the Raiders and dropped for a loss or a no gain on the play, and that's going to get that clock under a minute. It's rolling down here. You've probably got two more snaps left in this first half. It's 21-13. The Raiders' offense has not been stopped other than stopping ourselves.
Had two turnovers inside the 20-yard line of Vidalia and those kind of things. One was just a bad pass, and the other one, our receiver was trying to make a play and someone came from behind and knocked it loose, trying to be aggressive. But that's okay. We're still in this ball game. We're one score away from tying it up.
Second down, and they're going to hand it underneath. And I don't know, we tackled him there. We dove in as if there was a.
Coach Cofer's very upset with clock management up here, calling timeout, and he let about 3 seconds run off after Coach Cofer called timeout. He turns around screaming at the press box for the official to stop the clock.
Stay tuned for our halftime show. We're going to try to get Shane back on. We are having technical difficulties right now. Don't know if the batteries have run out in our wireless or whatnot. He can't pick us up right now, so we won't be able to hear from Coach Cofer, it looks like. But we do have some interviews for us. Tell us a little bit about our halftime lineup.
Well, we've got senior Aubrey Carter we're going to be talking to. And we've also got a special report, Red Raider report, that you don't want to miss with Daniel Ruiz. Daniel is a volunteer with our band and a great football fan, big Georgia fan, big Red Raider fan. He's at all the football games, volunteers his time, and he's the percussion assistant. He takes care of our drums, and just listen to what he has to say about it. There's a lot that goes on besides between the lines on the football field. There's a lot of things that take place. Cheerleaders, band, there's a lot of parents involved, a lot of volunteers involved that makes all this come together for a great Friday night of high school football in South Georgia.
And it's going to be third down and forever. 26 is what they're marching it. 11:19 left to go, and they're going to come in their wing tee to the left, and they're going to hand it to their big guy, and he gets outside. We knock him down. Be fourth down, and we call a timeout.
Six and a half seconds left, and that's going to be fourth down. And I don't know if that wasn't fourth down. So I have all ideas. He's just going to take a knee, or they're going to do something. I don't. Do we have any more timeouts left? I can't tell.
Even if he took a knee, we would still get one snap from the offense.
Yep.
It'd be a turnover on down and blow it down. So I don't think he would take a knee right here.
No, not with our ability to throw the ball deep.
He may throw it. He may pitch it and run around or something and fall down, because you can do that in 6 seconds. But if not, you're just getting too cute. Of course, I don't know. We had a snap over the head. So
I think that's what Coach is hoping, that they'll try to punt the ball.
We could return it. Brooks County 20, Early County 13, Clinch County 51, Lanier 0. Looking for some scores from around the region. 22-12, Irwin on top of Wilcox County. And Pierce 21, Applin 14. And let's see what they're going to come out, and they're back to punt the ball here as they snapped it over his head last time, and I'd love for it to happen again. Trey Stewart standing at about the 42-yard line. Their time, they get the snap off, and they get the kick up, and they kicked it away from Trey.
Out of bounds.
And we should have about 2 seconds left to go on the clock when that thing went out of bounds. However, we have 1.4, and we're going to have one play here. And I just hope we don't try to run it deep and throw a pick and they run it back. It's always dangerous, but
the officials have, you know, I don't know what they've done as far as being able to call anything on the field, but they've let the game be played. But right there, that was a terrible officiating situation there with that ball punted out of bounds, because the White hat didn't mark it like he should have.
They'll throw it underneath, and we're going to run it across, and it's a pitch. We got our speed guy who can't break the tackle, but he's knocked out of bounds at the 25-yard line.
Good play.
And a good little trick play as Aubrey dropped back through it to a little slant, crossing pass to LeGondrick Snell, and he flipped it behind him to Ignacio Washington coming on the other side. Good little trick play, good little try there by the Raiders. However, at the end of the first half, it's 21-13. Your Indians are on top. And it looks like we're going to go down to our Eyes on the Field, brought to you by Family Vision Care. Shane Bennett was Coach Ken Kofer. Shane, do you have Coach? He's pulling his microphone out, and I don't know that he does. So we're just going to
wrap it up then. We'll be talking to you in the second half. Come back. We've got a barn burner going on here as Vidalia Indians lead us 21-13. We're going back to the studio. You're listening to Red Raider Radio on 93.5 The Eagle.
This year, the band has been inviting audiences to go back to school. Tonight, we take you back into math class. That means all songs contain numbers and their titles. This is special generational math class. First, for the baby boomers generation, your math quiz comes from the group Chicago. This song has been suggested as an answer to their first hit. Does anybody really know what time it is? The answer song come on their second album, 25 or 6 to 4. If this is true, then the answer would be 3:35 or 3:34. It does not say a.m. or p.m.
Not even in the top 25 and got beat 55
and now here they for the Generation Z, also known as the Millennials, we feature our flag line in a traditional band format. We close high stepping to Beyonce's 7-Eleven.
I'd rather have national championship than I had money, because that's all they was money. That state hat will win, and they'll get a dirt bowl. If they're on the field, they'll get a dirt bowl. Toilet bowl. have lost the get up and go on offense. We seem to pick it up on offense. Still. Boy, that Hurricane Patricia sustained 225-mile-an-hour wind. Sustained. It's just about to hit.
The Sound Tribe, everyone. Thank you for your attention. Class is now dismissed for the evening.
Hey, how you doing?
Tonight, the band will be performing selections by Fallout Boy, Centuries, Uma Thurman, and American Beauty. We hope you enjoy the show, and thank you for your attention. Oh,
first half.
Hey, guys, welcome back. I was we live on the cutting edge of technology. Sometimes you bleed. We had some technical difficulties there. Guys, locker room atmosphere was all business. I know we talked about that, and I hate to even say that, but they think they found something with the defense to make the adjustments. Again, we're playing a lot of young guys, playing folks out of their positions, but it was just taking a little bit to mesh, and I hope now with the adjustments they made, we're going to be at least able to slow them down from what we were in those first three possessions by they had the first half. Offensively, Jacob Carver, he took a little juice at halftime. He looks good. Retaped him. Hope he'll be back out in the second half. No injuries to speak of coming back in out of the locker room. All business, they're ready to play some football in the second half.
Fantastic. Thank you, Shane. They did crank the clock up and give us three more minutes. So as our teams are warming up and the music is playing, our fans are filing back in from concession stands. There's some people that we would like to thank that work in our Boosters Club every year. Shane is one of our Boosters Club members, and we have an array of folks that work really, really hard. Shane Bennett over our Red Raider Booster Club, Touchdown Club, is the president. Tim Allman is the vice president. Brent Johnson is the treasurer. Claudia Allman is the secretary. Joe Hayes does a tremendous job in fundraising. We had him on a couple of weeks ago in our Red Raider report, and where 4 or 5 years ago we were talking about a budget of $10,000 to $12,000 a year. Now we're talking a budget of somewhere between $50,000 and $75,000 a year, which is outstanding for a town the size of Bacon County. We love our football and we love our program, and you can see it. Our kids have good helmets, they have good equipment. We've got a fine stadium. Our community and our county is just on the way up. We're just a little bit away from having that breakaway football season. We see it in the future. It's coming for us. Right now, we're still trying to piece together. Our numbers are down sometimes, just a little bit, not from where they have been in the past, but down compared to some of the other bigger double-A schools. We really probably should be a single-A school, but we're competitive on the double-A level, and that's all that you can ask for us at this point. Looking forward to the second half of this game. As Shane was saying, our coaches think they may have found something that will help us defensively, and that's what we need. I think our offense can score. We were able to get inside or in the red zone twice in the second quarter, just not able to convert it into points, and I feel like we'll be able to do that in the second half.
That's right. You're listening to 93.5 The Eagle.
In this moment, it doesn't matter if you save money in 15 minutes. It doesn't matter if your neighbor has the same insurance that you do. What matters right now is the quality of your independent insurance agent.
Glad you're okay, Sarah. We'll take care of everything.
And the company that stands behind them.
Thanks so much for your help.
No problem.
Auto Owners Insurance.
Bennett, Bennett & Johnson Insurance Agency in Alma is your local independent auto owner's insurance agency.
It's ready for kickoff. Before we do, let's go back to Our Eyes on the Field, brought to you by Family Vision Care. Shane Bennett has the first half stats.
Real quickly for you, 179 total yards from Vidalia. That was 2 for 3 in the passing area, 22 total yards passing. And on the ground, 24 attempts for 157 yards for Vidalia. Total 179 yards, 13:07 time of possession. Bacon County, 15 for 19 in the passing area for 143 yards, 2 touchdowns. On the ground, we had 24 total yards for a total of 167 yards and time of possession, 10:53. So the game is tight, as the score shows, guys. Should be a good second half.
Yeah, we're ready for it. You said it earlier, Rev, as this has a feel of the Pierce County game, and then it started slowing down a little bit. But Bacon County basically, bottom line, shot ourselves in the foot twice in the first half. That's behind us now. Aubrey Carter has the ball spotted on the 40, and we're going to kick it. We're going to kick it this time about the 22s where he takes it. And we've got a host of Raiders who hit him and knock him down. Big number 41, Tyler Wilcox. That man, Trace Stewart, who's becoming a force to be reckoned with.
He's beginning to like to tip people, which is what we need our safety to do. And their number 7, he was tiptoeing that time. Somebody's rung his bell for him. He didn't really want it.
You mentioned Trey looking like Tron. I could remember the progression of Tron Folsom over the years from his freshman year to his senior year. And about his junior year, Tron started liking a little bit of contact. He would hit people, but he started loving it about his junior year. Vidalia ball on the 30. They're going to take it, hand it to their big fullback, and Trey files up in there and knocks him down after a gain of about 4 yards. And he shot out of a cannon there, as Trey Stewart did, to meet their fullback, who probably weighs about 230.
Yeah, he's a big kid. Looks like a gain of about 3.5. A short 4, a long 3. And number six for them is coming in. And
ball is on the 34-yard line.
He's a senior, Sean Jones, and he's got a big, heavy wrap on his arm. I think he's one of their running backs that's been hurt. He may be dangerous.
He's ran the ball some tonight, and he gets it that time, and he cuts back up, and he got a host of Raiders, but he's dragging folks. One of their big linemen to get in there and push him across the 40 to the 41-yard line, and two plays, and a Vidalia first down.
Yeah, he is strong, big. He's not as big as some of the others, but he's quick.
That is one rule that I cannot stand.
Is lineman being able to push?
Yes, lineman being able to push. I hate that. I think it's unfair. Everything we do, we take away from the defense, but we add to the offense. Scoring points and making money is what it's become about. 10:58 here in the third quarter. It's 21-13. Vidalia on the 41-yard line. They're going to take it and hand it to their fullback. Quarterback pulls it, and we drop him back the line of scrimmage. I don't know. Somehow he snuck across for a gain of a yard. Second down and 9.
When he's fighting like that, we sure need a middle linebacker to come in there and spin him around
and
one time.
It really looked like it. It looked like he dove right up underneath it.
We're small, and we're going down for their legs to try to get them down. We need somebody that can come in up high and deliver a lick to them, let them know we're still around.
So far, Charlton 7, Telfair nothing. And that's a war. Jeff Davis, I know you said 0-0 at half, one of the fastest first halves in the history of high school athletics. They'll send their guy in motion. They're going to hand it. Oh, it's a little reverse counter, and they caught us. And he makes a move. And let's see, he's got one man to beat. We chase him down from behind as he crosses over into our territory. And they're going to mark him down at the 25. It's actually going to be about the 26-yard line, 27. First down for Vidalia, and they ran a first little wrinkle that we've not seen yet.
Was that a counter?
And broke it. It was a counter.
Yes.
It was almost a reverse.
Yeah, it was just a true counter, and pulled one way and came the other, and had us caught, trying to get us to keep us from jamming the line like we do.
Coach Kofer brings K.J. Brown over to ask him what happened. They hand it. That loosened it up a little bit. A gain of 5 for their big fullback. Second down and 5 for Vidalia.
.934.
Think of the same thing.
Great minds think alike. .934. They're on their own or on our 22-yard line.
And they're marching in, and we need to hold them. We can score quick, but we need to hold them in their opening series just to send a message. They're going to come out in their double twin set. They got their big fullback in the backfield. Number 18 sends number 6 in motion. They hand it to him, and he gets the outside. Makes a cut. He's up the middle, down around the 5. He's spinning at the 5-yard line. We bring him down. First and goal for the Indians.
And that was the good old-fashioned buck sweep. The one thing that we've not been able to stop hardly all year. We've had trouble with it all year. It was what they were gashing us with in the first quarter, and we seemed to put an end to it. But now they've come back and are attacking our edge again.
Big Dakota Screws and Tyler Wilcox come onto the field for the Raiders in this big first and goal, crucial opening drive of the second half.
We need a big stop right here. We need somebody to make some penetration.
There's one thing we are not going to be able to say, we will be able to say after this game. Quarterback pulls it, and he gets down at the 1-yard line. We've had our opportunities. You say, well, you sound like you're already giving the victory to them. That's not what I'm doing at all. I'm just simply saying right now it should be 28-21.
It should be.
And there comes Dakota Screws off holding his left shoulder, and that doesn't look promising.
No. Need somebody to look at him.
They're hollering for the trainers. He's up. He's okay. He just looks like they're going to try to have to wrap it. Quarterback sneaking. We hold him.
Yep.
Just going to be short of the first down, and that'll be third down and goal, and a good stop by the Raiders. Third and goal here. They tried to sneak it. That's a big quarterback, but we held him. Oh, I wish I could see. We're way up here, high at Raider Field. Sometimes we can't see down there.
Looks like they're just inside the 1 yard line. The nose of the football, the back nose of the football is actually sitting on the one. So they're about 2.5 feet away.
And they're going to come out in their double twin set. And he's going to try to sneak it again. And this time he got in. Touchdown. It still looked like we had him in the backfield for a moment. And Vidalia going to make it 27-13 here quick. 7:36 left in the third quarter. They ran off some clock. And they're going to attempt the extra point and try to make it 28-13. This game is far from over, folks. They're going to run big George Lopez out onto the field. George has played well for us this year. He's played right guard. They snap it. The kick is up. And the kick is good. It's 28-13. Vidalia early scores on their opening drive. When you come back, the Raiders from Bacon County will have their opportunity to answer. You're listening to 93.5 The Eagle.
In this moment, it doesn't matter if you save money in 15 minutes or if your neighbor has the same insurance that you do. What matters right now is the quality of your independent insurance agent and the company that stands behind them. Auto Owners Insurance.
Bennett, Bennett & Johnson Insurance Agency in Alma is your local independent auto owners insurance agency.
Welcome back, everybody. As Vidalia comes out, the kicker is setting the ball on the tee, and they're getting ready for a kickoff. They've used several types of kickoffs to us tonight. They've pooch kicked it. They kicked it deep one time, and the one time Trey Stewart broke it and brought it back up to midfield. He was one player away from breaking it all the way.
I'm going to say they don't kick it deep this time.
I would think you would be right on that.
23, he's kind of had a crazy night as he's dropped a snap on the punt. And this time they're going to kick it, pooch it high. We fair catch it at the 25-yard line. We've had a couple series where we've started on this side of the 30-yard line, but that's where we'll take over the 25-yard line, and Aubrey Carter comes out at the quarterback position to open up the second half for the Raiders.
Yeah, we need to come down and score and at least keep it within one score. You never know what's going to happen.
K.J. Brown, that's true of the Pierce County game. K.J. Brown in the backfield. We've got twins to the top and to the bottom, and Aubrey's waiting for the official to blow the whistle. Barks the hard count, looks up. Gives a signal, gets the signal from Coach Matt Williams. Aubrey standing at our 20 in the shotgun. He's going to send KJ in motion. And Aubrey takes it and he rolls to the right. And he has to step up in the pocket. And he's dropped and sacked back at the 20-yard line.
Well, Aubrey run right into that.
He did. He ran a little too far. He tried to step up and the guy, sometimes when you're blocking, you just, as a blocker, you can't see where the quarterback's at, but the defender can.
They're barking a little bit at KJ, but I'm not really sure that was KJ's fault.
Absolutely.
Aubrey should have stepped inside a little bit. You disagree?
Absolutely.
Totally disagree with me?
You totally completely. KJ was not physical enough on that play. All right, we've got twins to the top and to the bottom, and Jacob Carver's checked in at the fullback position. Now we're going to roll that way and throw it out to number 15, and he's quick. He catches it, gain of probably 2 yards on the play, not enough. It'd be third down and maybe 14 for the Raiders as they backed us up deep here early in the third quarter on our first possession. So the ball is spotted at the 24-yard line. And it's third down and 12 for the Raiders, 6:24. It's 28-13. Vidalia come out and score on their opening drive. We send Brody Fitchett across the motion,
motioning to the trips,
and Aubrey drops straight back. We throw it, bad pass by Aubrey as it was thrown behind number two. And the Revs pointing down here as LeGondrick Snell was running
wide open.
Wide open.
They're not
down
giving
the sideline.
They're not giving him any whatsoever, any respect out here. I hope our coaches upstairs are able to see that. He's wide open for a touchdown. When Aubrey goes back the other way, if he'll just turn and fire it down this sideline, it's six.
They do have their best cornerback on LeGondrick Snell. Maybe that's what's keeping our coaches from even looking that way. Number 10 is also their running back. He's a sophomore. We're going to drop back and kick it this time. And oh, they almost blocked it, but they didn't. Ball hits at the 50, and it bounces across the 45 and down at the 41-yard line. And that's where Vidalia will take over on offense. 6:03 here in the third quarter. It's 28-13. They scored, we didn't, and now we got a hold, or this game could become a blowout quick.
That was very, very close to being blocked. And I tell you, honestly, if I had to say where we're just not playing very well, our line, our offensive line is just not playing very well.
They run by us at times tonight. They just a little bit,
they need to suck. We need to suck it up a little bit. If we got to narrow our gaps a little bit, whatever, we've got to create – we got to be able to do something on the offensive line. They were rushing three people then on the punt and almost blocked.
They're going to hand it off and on a buck sweep, and they get a couple, two or three, and he's brought down a good tackle. We're doing a much better job tackling the second and third quarter, and he was brought down by Xavion Brown, number 31, for the Raiders.
This is huge. If we can get behind right here and not be able to catch up, we need to stop. We need to stop bad.
Second down and eight, ball at the 43-yard line, and I definitely agree with you there. We definitely have to have a stop here. A turnover, pick six, or fumble six would be good right here for our Raiders. Let's go, guys. Second down and eight. They've done it several times tonight.
We need to bow our backs.
Double wing set for Vidalia. They're going to take it and hand it. Their big guy, he's met in the backfield, but, boy, he just drugged some of us for, 4 yards there. That pound for pound is definitely advantage to Vidalia. Our guys are playing their hearts out. That ball is going to be spotted at about the 47-and-a-half-yard line. Third down and four.
And big Akeem Peterson's coming in. And we're running
Jesus Brown off. They rotate those two in. And this time they're going to go to an unbalanced set to the left, as Shane was talking about earlier. They're going to hand it to their quarterback, and there he goes. He broke a tackle, and he's there across the 40, and we get him from behind, but he holds on to the football. First down, Vidalia. They sucked us in there, and quarterback Reed, and a good job by number 18, and that's a first down. They're in our territory now.
On our 34-yard line, 4 minutes and 35 seconds left as the clock's ticking. We still got an opportunity to stop them right here.
Just an unfortunate situation there, as it was kind of a pile-up, and he bounced out of the pile-up. It was really a cutback. However, it's first and 10 on the 34 for Vidalia. They get us to jump, as they almost got us to jump on the big third down. We did it that time, and the whole defense is going to do some push-ups, and they really need to save their strength. I've always liked that tactic, but when you're playing against some big guys, it's just a little bit of humor here, as it's fixing to get bad if we don't make a stop.
Yeah, we've had the opportunity. We really needed a big stop. Looked to me like we come out just a little bit flat in the second half, and we just can't afford to do that.
So we got double wings here. Vidalia going to send that number 10. They're going to pitch it out to him to the left.
And he's Wesley got some gets blockers. Him cut back in.
Good job by Wesley Cothran of forcing a cut back in, and Jacob Carver cleaning it up. But it's going to be close to a Vidalia first down.
I think it is a first down. I'll be surprised if they don't give it to him. Nope,
it's going to be third down and inches.
Yep.
Third down and inches, and anything could happen. We still got a chance. It's still life. 3:24, 28-13, Vidalia. Third down and inches from our 25-yard line. They're going to hand it on the counter, and it's wide open. Five, touchdown, Vidalia. They've ran that play twice.
Same
result. Second time, touchdown.
Yep.
And that puts it at 34-13, and they've opened up a can of worms.
Yeah, they've opened up a big lead on us.
But
we can talk about it. You can't cry over spilt milk, but we really needed to be able to, when they made mistakes, we needed to be able to capitalize on it. They capitalized on our mistakes, and we've not been able to capitalize on theirs.
We never give up. That's one thing about our Raiders, and so this game is not over till it's over. And there's a flag, and I don't know what that flag is going to be on. And it was thrown. Let's see what it's going to be. Is that going to be a sideline warning?
Sideline warning?
Yeah.
4199. We're getting ready for the kickoff. Vidae is still hooded up on their sideline.
I'd like to go down to Shane Bennett as Coach Kofer is talking to the official down there. Shane, can you tell us what Kofer is barking at down there on the sideline?
Well, he was just trying to find out what the yardage was on the penalty. It's a 15-yard penalty, so it's going to be
What was the call, Shane?
Well, from what I understand, running into the kicker. I didn't see that, but that's what they're calling.
So a 15-yard penalty running into the kicker on the Raiders, and that will give their guy a chance to kick it through the end zone. Ball's going to be placed at the 45-yard line. The Raiders 45-yard line, and he is going to kick it deep and into the end zone. And in high school football, once it's caught in the end zone or not, it cannot be brought out. So the Raiders will start at the 20-yard line. Is it the 20 or the 25?
I think it's 20 in high school.
20-yard line, and they'll have a chance. And if we've got a chance to stand in this game, we've got to score on this series.
We absolutely got to score, then we've got to get a stop.
And score, stop, things, score, and we're in it.
Right.
35-13. We're going to look through some scores in just a few moments to keep you updated so that you don't turn the dial. Don't turn the dial, even though we're down by a couple of scores, because anything can go. We've seen crazy things happen. If you go back to the Pierce County game last year, this year and even last year, Aubrey sticks it in the belly and dumps it, just a arid pass as he was being rushed. And this is the first time we've really seen Aubrey under some duress consistently. And so your true colors as a quarterback comes out when you're under duress. Speaking of that, the greatest quarterback that's in the game today, Tom Brady and Aaron Rodgers, one of the adjustments Brady's made this year is he moves around like Aaron Rodgers does. And he's a veteran. He throws it to a wide open and just skips it as he had somebody in his face again. He's got to step into his throws. Incomplete. Third down and 10. The ball is on our 20-yard line. And Wesley Cothran's coming off the field as a linebacker for them put him on his tail that time. You don't see that many times from Cothran. Cothran plays both ways. A lot of our guys do. They're fighters, folks. 3:04 here in the third quarter. It's 35-13.
We're going to try to go deep right here.
We have no choice, and there's nothing for Aubrey. Nothing for Aubrey. No blocking or nothing there.
They're starting to turn it up now. They're three scores ahead, and they're blitzing everybody, and they're coming from everywhere.
Well, Rev, can I just stop you there for a moment and actually tell you that they dropped back in coverage? They had three down linemen. They did blitz off of the outside, but they brought four guys, and the defensive lineman just pushed our guard down and ran back and caused Aubrey to run into their outside linebacker. And Aubrey's going to kick it, and the ball's going to bounce at the 40 and bounce out of bounds at the 49-yard line. They'll be on our side, and field position is in their favor here. 2:09, 2:19 left in the third quarter, and it's 35-13.
You're listening to 93.5 The Eagle.
50-yard line. They hand it to their big man who goes forward for a gain of five. And it's going to be second down, well, a gain of six where they spotted it. Ball's at our 44-yard line, and it'll be second down and a long four, well, long five there, Rev.
Yeah, this fullback, this offensive line just giving him creases. And when you're getting 5 yards at a clip, it doesn't take long. And we're trying our best to stop the bleeding, and then all of a sudden they hit us with a big one with a counter, or they go wide with us.
Well, their size is starting to take over, and you got to remember we got a lot of guys going both ways, but tonight it's really affected us. They're going to hand that counter off, and it's another big gain. And they got some big guys out there, and he's got one man to beat. He crosses the field. He's at the 20. He's at the 10, the 5, and he walks in. Touchdown on the counter. Number 6,
yep.
Vidalia, 41-13. My Lord. Let's look at some scores while they set up. Brooks County, 27. Early County, 12. Applin County, 35. Pierce County, 28. You two guys up here in the booth tried to tell me, and I said, Pierce County, I kill them. But Applin County stepping up. The Indians of Irwin County, 36. Wilcox County, 12. Dodge, 14. Cook, 7. That's a surpriser. Fitzgerald, 21. Pelham, 0. The kick is up, and the extra point attempt is good. 42-13 here. When we come back, we're going to get the ball on offense, and we're going to hear from our eyes on the field, Shane Bennett. You're listening to 93.5 The Eagle.
In this moment, it doesn't matter if you save money in 15 minutes or if your neighbor has the same insurance that you do. What matters right now is the quality of your independent insurance agent and the company that stands behind them. Auto Owners Insurance.
Bennett, Bennett & Johnson Insurance Agency in Alma is your local independent auto owner's insurance agency.
To 13, Vidalia has busted it open here in the third quarter. We got a minute 31 left. I want to give a shout-out to our Lady Raiders of Bacon County. Made it to the Sweet 16 and got put out by the defending, they made it to the championship game last year, Gordon Lee, and was able to be there that game. We'll talk about it in just a moment. They're going to kick it, and it goes through our guys, but then Trey Stewart gets it. When he gets it, he's dangerous. Jumps over a guy, and he shoots up the middle. And, man, that guy's electric, isn't he?
Well, that was actually LeGondrick Snell.
Was it?
Yeah. And he was just a little bit away from returning it. I wish he'd let Trey had it.
We do have some laundry on the field, though. It's right down there in front of Shane, if he's still in that spot. Shane, our eyes on the field brought to you by Family Vision Care. Did you see the penalty?
Oh, they're out there talking right now. A minute and 24 seconds left in the third quarter, and they're discussing it. They're going to wave the flag off, and we're going to get the ball at the 42-yard line. Our own 42-yard line, so we're in a pretty good position.
Down there at the field, but I looked up and noticed he was helping the cheerleaders out, cheering the game on there.
All right, hand the ball off. Let's punish some people right here.
All right, we got Aubrey Carter in at quarterback, and they're going to take it, and they're going to hand it to Carver. And he punishes a couple people and goes across the 45-yard line to about the 47. 46 and a half, somewhere around in there. Second down and manageable for the Raiders. That's the best, best offensive play we've had this quarter.
Yeah,
we're about under a minute here in the third quarter. Aubrey's in at quarterback. Jacob's in the backfield with him. Trips to the right, going to take it, going to hand it, dump it over to a man who was wide open, just missed him as we stuck play action to Carver, sucked him in, and couldn't hit Brody. Brody is a short little thing. If he ever gets his hands on the ball, though, he can do some damage. We've seen him take over some games this year at times.
Sure have.
However, it's third down and 6, and we've just not been able to catch a break in this third quarter and hit some of the plays we've hit all year long. Trips to the right, up to the top of the field. Ball's at the 46-and-a-half-yard line. Our 46 is going to throw it to a wide-open man, Xavier Hayes. Ball's going to be spotted at the 44-yard line. First down, Raiders.
Yeah, that looked good. That was a good play, good pass by Aubrey. Just the running the ball a couple of times just gives us a little – doesn't allow them to pin their ears back. They've got to play safe, and they've got to play their their regular option, you know.
We hand it back to Carver, and he goes up the field, and he's dragging folks, and they finally whistle it down after a gain of about 3 yards, second down and 7. What exactly what you're alluding to is it's fixing this clock. We probably got one more play. That running game just opens up the passing game so much, and sometimes we get away from it a little bit quick. Aubrey's going to drop back, and he's got a pocket, and he fires it across Xavier Hayes, caught at the 33-yard line, and, boy, Xavier is getting up limping a little bit, but he's become a good little threat as a wide receiver.
Yeah, he goes out there and sits down in that zone. In comes Ron Johnson, number 15. I think Ron's a senior.
Xavier has a lot of success because he is a Patriot fan, as am myself. Trips to the right, and we jump off
that
sides.
That was ugly.
Jump off sides. Dakota Screws and Jesus Brown started a little bit early. I don't know what was going on. I think it was on the center there that time because Aubrey was dropping back. Peter Simmons, yep. Peter's confused. He's holding his hands out. He's been in at center position. Peter's a senior and has played very well. Sometimes those big hefties can just get a little tired.
Peter's actually gained about 20 pounds to be able to play some more center this year.
Boy, he loves it, man.
He does. He's a good young man. He's not a kid anymore. He's a good young man.
Yep, and we have to remember that he lost his mom just last week. She battled her whole life, and we just wish Peter the best of luck and continue to keep Peter Simmons in your prayer. That's the end of the third quarter here at Raider Field. We're coming to you high atop the field. It's 42-13. Vidalia on top. You're listening to 93.5 The Eagle.
In this moment, it doesn't matter if you save money in 15 minutes. It doesn't matter if your neighbor has the same insurance that you do. What matters right now is the quality of your independent insurance agent.
Glad you're okay, Sarah. We'll take care of everything.
And the company that stands behind them.
Thanks so much for your help.
No problem.
Auto Owners Insurance.
Bennett, Bennett & Johnson Insurance Agency in Alma is your local independent auto owners insurance agency.
Back, everybody, as we start our fourth quarter of Vidalia 42, our hometown 13. We're going down to Shane Bennett on our eyes on the field, Family Vision Care eyes on the field. Shane.
Hey, guys, through three quarters, we got 34 yards rushing Bacon County, 162 yards in the air. Vidalia really blowing it up on the ground, 330 yards on the ground, 22 yards still passing. 22 minutes possession time on the clock for Vidalia, big difference there.
And they've held the ball and ran it down our throats in the third quarter, but it's the fourth quarter and things can change. Couple scores and a couple big defensive plays, and we're back in it. Aubrey going to drop back, and he's going to throw it.
Ron Johnson.
Complete to Ron Johnson, a senior, and it's good to see that young man catch a ball tonight. Ball at the 30-yard line. That brings us back to about second down and, I don't know, nine.
I'd run that same play with Anacio playing slot. And this time I'd run Anacio and let him kind of do an out and up. I believe you'd get six on the board.
Jacob Carver in the backfield. We bark a hard count to see what they're going to do, and they definitely were going to come on a blitz from the outside that corner, which that's their defensive end, so I don't know if it's really a blitz. We spread out the field. Aubrey's got some protection. He's got him on the seam. You caught it, and he caught it into traffic. First and goal for the Raiders. Good catch by Anacio. Says as soon as that ball hit his hands, he got hit over his back. And the Rev with the call. Hadn't heard anything from your buddy Les Evans tonight. Les,
well,
if you're out there, give us a shout-out.
Les is in Vidalia tonight. He and his wife are eating supper a while ago, and he's
going to hand it to Jacob Carver in the gain of maybe a yard on the play. They're celebrating.
Well, he's taking a weekend off. They got a home on the Altamaha River, and they just told me that they were listening to us tonight. He's not at home keeping up with the scores like he normally is.
Well, we miss you, big guy. We miss those scores rolling in. However, it's second down and 10.
Wide open right here.
Aubrey
there it
drops back, and he's got it. Oh, what a great play. It's going to be a pass interference call, but a good job by Vidalia getting his hands in there. And you called it slant there. It was a little too deep for me. The route was a little too deep to give the guy advantage to Vidalia. However, it's going to be first and goal from the
5-yard line.
Five?
Yeah, half the distance to the goal. You're getting your pros and your high school mixed up.
I don't watch much college football these days, thanks to Mark Rick and Georgia Bulldogs. I do watch the NFL a lot, though. Going to take it and going to throw it out, and there he goes. And he's brought down. He lunged forward. They're going to call him down. Come on, man.
Come on, dude.
Come on, man. Is he good effort by Inacio Washington, but he's going to be down at the one-yard line, and it'll be second and goal for the Raiders. And I either give it to number seven, a little quarterback read option here. We're going to stay in those trips, and that's what we're going to do, hand it to Jacob Carver. And he's met, and he had both hands. Did you see that? He had both hands up, but then he marked it short. Third down.
Jacob's grabbing his ankle again.
Third down and goal. And Jacob's going to get a week off next week. Is that third? That's fourth down. Don't know that that's right at all. He's trying to tell him the clock's still running. And I always gotta say something that makes your stomach rumble here. But the referee that's going the clock, he stole our food at halftime.
Did he?
He stole our food. You know why?
Why?
Because he said he wasn't walking down these big steps.
Is that right?
That's exactly right. So I'm a little
upset.
Well,
maybe he's asleep because he ate too much, because he just let about 30 seconds slip off. If he was concerned about running the clock as he was about eating, maybe we'd get our 30 seconds back.
Aggravated me a little bit there. His sidekick, however, was very respectful. There's two of them up here in the booth tonight. There's usually one. Maybe that's a trainee, but he allowed our cameraman to eat a hamburger. Dadgummit, you're beating us on the field, or by day he is. We're going to fuss about something now. I'm ready to fight up here. It's ready to fight. So we got a timeout here on the field. 10:08, the third quarter, 42-13. And the Raiders are breaking out of their huddle. And the field side marker showing fourth down. The scoreboard's showing third. I kind of got lost in looking for scores, so I'm not sure.
Well, on the penalty, we shouldn't have been assessed a down.
It should be third down. Let's see what we do. We bring Jewel into the game, and Jewel's known for his legs and his blocking. Wesley Cothran in at the horseman position, and music's blaring.
Touchdown.
Touchdown, Raiders. Wesley Cothran's second effort gets in. I couldn't hardly think for the music going. We're lucky we didn't get a penalty. Let's celebrate, Rev.
Touchdown.
Got a good long play. Way to go.
Yeah.
42-19.
That was a little bit high, and Wesley done a good job of corralling that thing in. I think the same guy that's operating the clock, is operating the music. Well, they were enjoying a good conversation. We're going to go for two right here. I don't blame us to try to make it a three-point. Illegal substitution, what was that, against them?
They marked it against us, pointed our way.
No, it's a sideline warning on them. He was mad about the play before with music playing.
And you heard that from Shane, our eyes on the field. And we're going to go for two and roll Aubrey Carter out. And he's looking, and he throws it out of the back of the end zone. But there's a flag in the vicinity of holding, and we'll see what happens. Holding on the Raiders. That penalty will be declined, and it's 42-19. We're going to take a quick break. When you come back, we're going to kick it off. You're listening to 93.5 The Eagle.
Kickoff team runs across the field getting ready to kick off. It's been a great night for football here in South Georgia. And I know that the seasons are beginning to wind down. We've still got a couple of games left after this, and we're fighting for a playoff berth. And I'm excited about what's going on here in Bacon County. Really, the community is really turning out. Our Board of Education is doing a super job. And I'm just excited about what's going on here. As you was alluding to, our girls softball team is – and Coach Stephen Tyre and his staff are good each and every year. And And from the middle school level, we talked about it in the beginning of the game. Coach Kofer alluded to it at halftime. Our middle school football team has a very good team, so we've got some people in the pipeline, and we've got some athletic big men that's down in that's eighth graders are going to be up on the varsity next year on the ninth grade. And you know we play a lot of underclassmen here, so over the next couple of years we may be young, but we're going to be having some size. And there, onside kick, and the
that ball still flowing, rolling around, and they finally fall on it as our guys are just tired and couldn't. Of course, Aubrey kicked it about 25 yards. It rolled. If he gets a good, I don't know, he kicked it about, 15 that hit a guy.
Yeah.
We're trying an onside kick as we should. It's 9:59, and we are in the fourth quarter, correct?
That is right. I will say this, and I'm sure not about it making excuses, but as we look down from up here, our guys have taped up ankles. You can see, you know, just about every other one of our players is hobbling, grabbing shoulders. We've got issues. We just, this late in the season.
Strike up the buy-in, folks.
Yeah, yeah. This late in the season playing double-A football, we're just a beat-up football team.
They're going to pitch it out wide, and they blow a whistle. We got a false start again, Vidalia. Going back to talking a little bit about the region, Benedictine was up 48-0 at half. I don't know that we reported that one over Groves. Jeff Davis and Bryan are at a final, and Bryan County won 14-7. Jeff Davis gave up a big pass late in the ball game to Bryan County to come over. So that pretty much knocks us to fight for the fourth spot. Is that right? If we win out the next two ball games, we will secure a fourth spot. And so Bryan County turned out to be the surprise. I guess the most shocking game was McIntosh against Vidalia so far. However, Vidalia's got the ball. They're going to send a guy in motion. They're going to pitch it this time to the opposite side.
Play.
A good play by Wesley Cothran there on the play. He's a tough little joker, and he's played good for us all year long.
Sure
just
has.
A junior. He's got one more year here. We're going to miss him. He's been playing since his freshman year.
I tell you what happened to me the other day in the hall. I was shocked. I walked by. It was just me and him, and he said, "Hey, Mr. Peavy."
He is a man of few words.
I do watch him in the weight room. He's just a bulldog in the weight room. He's gaining weight and just getting bigger, stronger, faster. That's what he's all about.
He ran down one of their guys earlier. Oh, my.
Twice tonight he's done it.
We're going to come, and they're going to do another counter, and golly, they hit it again. And we just dragging folks, and he crosses the 35-yard line. First down for Vidalia.
That is the shortest the shortest play that they've had. We're running that play, and it was a 16-yard gainer.
Well, it took us 2 weeks, but we worked out the kinks, and we stopped the buck sweep, and now we've got the counter to work on this next week. So by the time we get to the playoffs, we'll be good and ready to go against this running games.
Our defense has played really good until we started facing the wing T teams, and the wing T has given us a fit on our defense. We're just not as Coach Kofer said, we're just not built to stop the wing T.
Sorry to cut you off.
It's all right.
Continue to talk. They get across the 45-yard line. It'll be 2nd and 9. As you were saying.
I was just saying, Coach, talking with him yesterday, and he talked about it in our pregame show. We're just not built to be able to set the edge. We're not big enough up front to be able to clog the middle and clog the things that we need to clog facing a wing T team.
McIntosh County 25, Long County 14, and it's basically going to come down to senior night 2 weeks from now, us against McIntosh Academy.
We can't forget.
Oh, and he got a big hole. He's across our 50 down to the 30-yard line, and he's brought out of bounds number 4 for Vidalia with a big gain. And one of their backup fullbacks, he's not been in there a lot. Trey Stewart brings him down. Trey's played like a madman and replaced. Remember, we're missing Metrius Williams, which is a huge.
That's been huge. For
huge
us.
Deal for the middle part of our lineup and really for the outside. We put Demetrius at outside a lot. Anthony Madison played like a madman for a quarter or so. It's 42-19.
We bring in Roberto Fernandez.
Maybe
the first action I've seen him on the field tonight.
The ball spotted at our 27-yard line, and Vidalia's knocking. 7:40 here in the fourth quarter, and that clock just can't run down fast enough. You start worrying. It looks like Vidalia is going to call a timeout because they're a little bit confused. You start to worry about injuries late in the ballgame. You're listening to the 93.5, the Eagle.
In this moment, it doesn't matter if you save money in 15 minutes. It doesn't matter if your neighbor has the same insurance that you do. What matters right now is the quality of your independent insurance agent.
Glad you're okay, Sarah. We'll take care of everything.
And the company that stands behind them.
Thanks so much for your help.
No problem.
Auto Owners Insurance.
Bennett, Bennett & Johnson Insurance Agency in Alma is your local independent auto owners insurance agency.
Is in their huddle and they're breaking the huddle. I don't expect them to do anything fancy here at all. They're just going to continue to run the ball. Their fancy play has been a counter play. They've only threw the ball three times tonight. And pitch it wide with the buck sweep, and here we go. Good play.
Number six and on the play, and he's brought down by Trey Stewart.
Yeah.
And Zebion Brown.
Zebion just he made an outstanding play. Zebion weighs about 135 pounds. Maybe 140, and he's about 5'5", and I'm not exaggerating when I say that. And he just engaged with a blocker, fought off the blocker, and dove into the man's legs. It's just pure heart, and held him for only about a 2-yard gain.
Thank you for coming out tonight. If you've already left and you're catching us, listen to it. We appreciate you coming out. If you've listened to us, we appreciate you tuning in. The Rev and I appreciate it. Very much so. They hand it to their fullback who goes forward for some tough yardage, about 4 yards on the play. Brings up third down and
five. Yeah, third and five. And this is the first time we've got them in a third and five in the one other time in the second half. 6:34, 6:33. They're on our own, on our 21-yard line. And
see,
they're checking players in and out.
Yep, they are. 6:20 here. And I'm already looking to the end of the show. We got to name the ATC Broadband Play of the Game at the end of the show, and hopefully we'll hear from Coach Kofer. They're going to hand it to their fullback,
there's a fumble. The ball.
And Trey Stewart. No,
oh, Trey.
Oh, my goodness. My goodness.
Trey.
My goodness. We
I don't
that
hardly
ball.
Blame him. I don't hardly blame him. I mean, I really don't. He's trying to pick it up and make something happen.
You got to down 42-19. However, that ball rolls across down at the 8-yard line, and Vidalia recovers it. It just come out of the fullback's belly and just bounced right into the hands of Trey, and he was unable to pick it up.
If he'd been able to pick it, he'd been close to scoring.
Yep.
And, you know, players like that has that ability. They need to try to take a chance like that. I'm not going to really fuss that much about it.
Yeah,
he's just trying to make a play.
That's exactly what that was, which Trey has been our playmaker at times this year. 5:46 here, 42-19, and it's first and goal for the Indians. And they're going to take it and hand it to their counter. This time
we stopped
the counter. We made an adjustment and stopped the counter, and that's good to see when you got a young defense. Finally, on the fifth counter of the night, we stopped it. It made an adjustment. Good job, guys. I'm not being a smart aleck. Some of you know I like to be a smart aleck, but I'm being as true can be.
I will say this. A while ago, we had a play. One of our offensive linemen made a mistake. And in the timeout, I noticed our coach, Coach Kiner, he was over here with that player, and he was coaching him, teaching him the proper steps to take. So, this is they're always coaching, and they're always positive with our kids, and I appreciate that about them.
Vidalia's got the ball second and goal now. They're going to take it, and they're going to pitch it, try to get the edge, and he gets across the down about the 3-yard line, across the five, and that'll bring up third down and goal for Vidalia. 4:42 here. It's 42-19. If you're just tuning in for some reason, where you been? If you're still with us and maybe you didn't hear, Bryan County 14, Jeff Davis 7. That is final. The last score we had from Benedictine at Groves was 48-0.
And Groves is coming in here tomorrow or next Friday night. I'm sorry for our homecoming.
And I hate homecomings.
I do too.
My goodness, at the distractions you have. Groves County, I don't know that they have the ability, even when we're distracted, to beat us. They're really down this year. They're going to hand it to number six, and he's going to walk in untouched. Touchdown, Vidalia. That just seals the deal here, and we're just going to have to wait for 4 minutes.
4:03. We got 4:03 left. The score is 48-19, and Vidalia is about to go for the extra point, which will make it 49-19, and we're going to be getting the ball back. We've still got a few fans left. The fans really, on the last score, begin to file out, but they've done a great job coming out tonight. We see a lot of people dressed in pink, breast cancer awareness, and some of our players are sporting socks and wristbands that are pink. And my mother is a cancer survivor. It was not breast cancer, it was ovarian cancer. But I really appreciate all the fundraisers and things that take place to try to head off and to come up with some cure for this dreaded disease. So all of you ladies and all of you people that in some way, somehow, most everybody's been affected by this disease, cancer. And we thank you for all the support, the money that we raise, and the awareness that we're trying to bring, and our community for getting involved in that.
Yep. Final from Benedictine, 68-0 is the final there. Looking for a Long County final. I know that McIntosh was up 25-14. Boy, if Long could beat them, that would have been good for us. Yep. That's still the score that we have. Extra point was kicked, and it was good. Now we're about to receive the kick. Ball's at the 40-yard line. And they're going to kick it deep to us. And they're going to kick it into the hands of Trey Stewart. He's going to catch it. And he's going to kind of come all the way across the field. He shoots up the middle. He got a couple guys to beat. And he's brought down at the 45-yard line.
Boy, he's a dangerous return, man.
My Lord. One block away from taking it to the house. And I love it when you got a player like that at any moment can take it. It's just exciting.
Sure is.
It's exciting.
I don't think it'd be an understatement to say that this would have been a little bit, here again I'm crying, but a little bit different game with a healthy Jacob Carver and a Demetrius Williams out there. I think the whole tone would have been a little bit different. Aubrey's going to take it,
and he's going to go up the middle, and he's going to cross the 50-yard line.
And go down, which was a good play.
First, it's going to be second down and five or four. Aubrey has done it by his last week. It was Aubrey and Inacio all night long. Aubrey on the ground, Inacio through the air.
Aubrey actually carried the ball 17 times. This
trips out here, and we're going to throw a quick screen across to Brody Fisher. We get a block. He's at the 45. He spins out of it. He's shifty. He's down the sideline. He's at the 40. And
we got a horse collar.
Knocked out of bounds. They're not going to call it at the 35-yard line, as the guy did let go. He had a hold of it. But he let go.
And that was a good play. It stopped the clock with 3 minutes and 15 seconds left. We're going to try to score.
I'm going to tell you something. If Brody Fitchett gets the ball in open space, he is dangerous.
He's just like a little pinball out there.
Yeah, he is. And this time we're going to throw it out to Inacio, and he catches it. And the guy just hammers him down. I don't know if he grabbed his helmet or not. That's kind of a weird play.
Yeah, it looked like his feet slipped out from under him or something.
Second down, loss of two. Second down and 12.
Nacio's down here at the bottom. I want to say bottom of your screen, but he's down here nearest our bench. LeGondrick Snell, he's up top. Both of them are wide, and we've got two slot. Actually, we got trips on one side and slots on the other.
Empty backfield. And they're going to send Inacio in motion and going to throw a quick screen to him. He's got some room. He makes a move trying
just
to get to the outside.
Inacio.
And he falls forward at the 35 back at the original line of scrimmage, close to it. And it's really going to be spotted at the 34-and-a-half-yard line.
2:19, 2:18, clock running down.
49-19.
Yeah.
We never take our foot off the pedal. We are always trying. Aubrey's running to his left and to his right to his receivers, barking. Empty backfield, five wide. Quarterback drops back in the pocket and throws it. A good pass. It's complete to that guy, Xavier Hayes. He's become a possession receiver. And Aubrey threw it.
Yeah, he sure did.
Into a tight window. First down, Raiders.
He's thrown some really good balls tonight. midway the third quarter, he was bouncing them a little bit, but he didn't have time to even think.
And Coach Kofer calls a timeout, and that clock's still rolling.
Guys, he's enjoying. He's actually come to a restaurant and a football game broke out. just playing.
Hey. But going back to the Raiders, the Lady Raiders, we were up at Chickamauga. How do you say it?
Chickamauga.
Yeah, nice little place up there. And the Lady Raiders had an opportunity, but just couldn't take advantage.
What kind of defense is this?
They're just dropping back in prevent, past the prevent. Aubrey's going to take off and run and take what they give him, slide down at the 15-yard line, and that's going to be close to a Raider first down as they're dropping back in prevent. It's not going to be a first down. It's going to be second down and one.
That was a good decision by Aubrey.
There's not much room to throw it here. A lot of these prevent situations, you have to throw it under the middle, underneath. At the 10, Nacio catches a little screen pass, first down for the Raiders, and that'll stop the clock for just a few moments. We're very good at being set and ready for when the whistle blows. The Raiders are knocking on the door here, and it's going to be first and goal. Throw it back out there. We got a few blockers, and Nacio gets north and south down at the 4. And that clock's just going to continue to tick. I sure would. Actually, that pass was complete to Snell. I said Inacio. You have to keep it straight there, Red.
Well, Snell is up at the top, and Inacio is down here to the bottom.
Be sure to stay tuned for the ATC broadband play of the game and the pregame show, postgame show. Aubrey going to take it 30 to 30 seconds. He's going to roll and stick it in there. Touchdown! Caught by number 9.
Ayrton Moore.
Ayrton Moore, his first reception of the night and first touchdown of the year. And a great throw by our quarterback, and we're probably going to go for two or just kick an extra point. 49-25.
I think at this point I would just kick an extra point because we missed one. I would just practice it.
It's a good call. However, it looks like we're going to go for it.
Yeah.
We just threw the tee completely off the field.
That's a great throw by Xavier Hayes. That tee actually had some movement on it.
Little curve. Be sure to stay tuned because Shane Bennett is going to bring us the post-game comments from Coach. We go for two here and throw it in there. Two-point conversion is good.
Xavier Hayes.
Bacon County 49. Bacon County 26. Vidalia 49 here with 26 seconds left to go in the fourth quarter. And let's just stay with it because we'll be giving you some breaks in just a few moments as we wait on Coach Kofer to address his team and then talk to our very own Shane Bennett, who has done a lovely job this evening. Vidalia coming to the game, and early on, Rev, really we were given all they wanted and just could not take advantage of some stops that we got from them. We were inside the 15-yard line twice, and that's if you can't score from the 15, you're just not going to win games like this.
Well, you know, the play of the game, if we really want to be honest, was the interception that we threw down here inside the 15-yard line. That was the thing that began to turn. Now, you may disagree with me, but I think that –
Well, I'm not going to name that the ATC play of the game. Not for us.
Well, I'm just saying that is the
– The play that changed the game, yes.
That was the play that changed the game. But if you want to call the play of the game, it may have been the first touchdown, that one-handed catch by – Inacio Williams.
You just really you really wonder in those situations, and all year long the coaches have done a great job at rotating those guys in, and we can sit up here and talk and pick and choose because we don't know sitting behind what we you know what they pulled out of their pocket. Onside kick attempt, and it's good, it bounces off the guy, but the big guy falls on it and they don't receive it. So Vidalia take a knee here. Ball's at the 50-yard line, but in those situations that's what can happen. Because if I'm not mistaken, that was his first series, Dawson Jewell's first snap from the ball game. And
wasn't that his second play?
Yeah, because Aubrey had been injured.
Right.
But you just – and last week he come in, the only series he really ran and drove us down the field and scored. But you just kind of get nervous when you put young guys in those kind of situations. And we had a delay game there, And just breaking it down for you, Coach wanted to save his timeouts, and no question about that. That'll do it here in Bacon County. They fall short 49-27. To continue our talk about the game, you save your timeouts, but you just have to wonder at times, and a little confusion on the field. Sometimes that two-quarterback system can bite you, and I think that's the first time all year long it did bite us. Now, if I'm a coach, this is what I tell you. He's worked all week long. He just got to execute.
Well, that is true, and I'm not taking anything away from our coaching staff. We put 27 points up on Vidalia tonight, and, you know, if we are a little bit healthier than what we are, 27 points, we're supposed to get 40. That's what we're shooting for. You take the 14 points that we left when we were inside the red zone, and we get our 40 points, and we're right where Coach wants us to be. So we had our opportunities. We were not able to execute tonight. I see the head coach of Vidalia is patting Aubrey Carter on the head. He's talking to him, congratulating him on what a great job that he's done. And Aubrey is really, this year, has he started off strong, but he's got stronger as the years went on. And he's showing senior quarterback leadership.
Yep, he's done a great job. We're going to go and go ahead and name our ATC broadband play of the game here. And as you were talking about Aubrey, and it happened on our first drive of the ball game, Aubrey hit Inacio Williams down the sideline, and Inacio brought in a one-handed catch, an outstanding high school catch. Last week, the catch he caught on the slant diving. Do you remember that?
Yes.
At Jeff Davis, and then tonight, the one-handed catch in the end zone. And so that's your ATC broadband play of the game.
Again, we want to wish Wesley, I say Wesley.
Dakota
Screws. Wesley is his dad. Want to wish Dakota Screws a happy 18th birthday. He played good tonight. He looked like he tweaked his shoulder a little bit, but just a few plays, he was back out there. And I noticed him during the game. He kept moving his shoulder, kept moving his arm, trying to get some feeling back in it. Our kids are out there. They're playing tough. They're playing hurt. But next week, we got homecoming. It's going to be a big week here at Red Raider Field 2015. We're
going to be sure to come out and support these kids.
Yeah, just come out. We
You can go deer hunting later, all right?
Well, we had a great crowd here tonight. We can't fuss about our crowd here tonight. Vidalia brought a good crowd. Both bands performed well, and it's been a good, clean football game. I have to say, for the most part, I felt like our officials done a good job tonight. At least they let us
besides
continue.
The man who stole our dadgum food. I'm still mad about that. He stole our food. We're going to take a quick break here. We appreciate you. Hang on there, because we're going to hear from the old head ball coach, Coach Ken Cofer, and what his thoughts were on the game when we come back. You're listening to 93.5 The Eagle.